here is our secret weapon. We have another mold in the burnout kiln, and this is what you hear clicking. What it's doing is it's controlling the gas, the extra gas going to the burner. This all controls the temperature through a PID. These things are magic to me. But a PID, you know, we set the temperature we want as 1,000 degrees. It has a K-type pyrometer in there, a pyrometer. I don't know what you call them. It's a temperature thing. And then this is the actual temperature that it's at. And when it gets too high, it stops adding additional gas. And when it gets down low, it starts actuating that the valve and adds a little bit more gas. See, all it does here is there's a T coming off the tank, and this line just goes up. I had a regulator up here, but that didn't work out. I'll tell you why in a bit. And then it comes down through this valve, and that kind of regulates, kind of like a pilot light. You know, that keeps the burner on and running, but not enough to bring the temperature up to 1,000 degrees. And then this regulator is on. We got it taped so it didn't wiggle loose. And then that PID just opens this valve up and lets additional gas in. That's what keeps it at 1,000 degrees, okay? And this regulator up here, when I did that, when this thing kicked on, it actually pushed back pressure up and a little bit of gas leaked out the regulator. So we just did away with it. And sure enough, Redneck Engineering wins again.
Venting whatsoever, just a little bit off that one vent.
There it goes.
Look at that.
Oh!
Yeah!
Okay.
Now this is going to flame up and knock it out.
Now back to the easier. Now, we did an experiment on the side here, too. We actually just put some styrofoam in there. It's called lost foam casting, and I've done it with aluminum. It literally burns it away and makes a part in one step. So, who knows? Maybe that's what we should have been doing all along, because that's just beach sand. And this looks gorgeous. We got a well up here on our vent, but that's fine. We got it sucked down through the pour cup, but it didn't take in too much metal, so I think it's gonna be good. A little shrinkage in this part, it's no big deal. I mean, it's just a capstan, so. And we're happy. The other thing we're happy about seeing is, in the dark, you can actually see that little vent hole right there, and that one there, and this one here, all have color in them, which means they've got metal right up to the top. So, yee doggy.
Whoa,
wow.
Red. That's nowhere near the sea I thought it would be.
Is that the sea?
Yeah, it's got a sea.
Yeah, it is.
Whoa.
Wow, look at that one. That actually worked pretty dang good. This one didn't fill, but we didn't have enough metal for it.
Wow. Not enough pressure holding the sand in?
Yeah.
Yeah, it just kind of like pushed
it
out.
This one's still got molten material in it.
Whoa.
Okay, well, that answers the question about opening it too soon. But look at that, that's not bad right there, but over where it, you know what? Where it ran in for a long time, it jacks it up.
Yeah, yep.
But where it went to immediately, that's pretty good. Oh, you know what? This isn't metal, it's sand that's glowing orange.
Oh, whoa.
Nothing spilled out, it just looked like it spilled out. Oh, that is, just does my head. Yeah, that's not a good way to make a casting. But you know what? If we just barely invested if I went back to step one, maybe this would work, which is you take a foam pattern and you dip it in sheetrock mud and you let that dry on there or slip or anything else, and then put that in the sand and pour that to maintain the integrity of the walls just a little bit longer. But see, what we're doing is we're hitting that, and we ought to use a pour sprue that's you know, we could cast something out of sodium silica sand for the sprues, like a pour cup.
Oh yeah.
So the metal hits it and it doesn't erode it. Because I'm hitting that, we're pouring it and it's hitting that sand, it's washing it.
But sodium, like a top layer of sodium silicate.
No, just all the pour cups, right down to the part. So I always have this foam. And so you pour it, it hits the foam, it goes through the foam, and then it fills up, becomes your riser. It's your pour cup and your riser and everything. All right, 15 hours later, we just took it out of the sand, and it is actually still too hot to touch. And you can see this big crack that opened up, but we think that probably happened afterwards or during the cooling, because there's no metal in it. We'll see when we break it open here. We got 99% good piece, and we can fix what we don't. We got some voids over on this side. You can see there, it's actually pitted, and I can fill that with weld and fix that. But otherwise, we're happy with it. On the first pattern I made, I put a rim on it along here, and that would be a good idea to give it something to draw from, and probably a riser on both sides of it, because I think what it's doing is it's shrinking back away. So we can use this one and improve the next one. And it had a crack along the bottom that just made some metal ooze out. And it's got these little bumps on it, but none of that's really a big deal. Mostly the surface is in pretty good shape, you know, for something that's gonna have chains wrapped around it. Its life is not gonna be a fun one after this anyway.